Hi children, in the previous videos you have seen what is phrase, clause and sentence, and here you are going to see the kinds of sentences. Just to recollect, I will say phrase is a group of words, two or more words which has no verb, so it will not give complete sense. Clause, it has verb, a finite verb, and it may have phrase and it will have some complete meaning. And in one sentence there may be more than one clauses too. One clause or another, some more clauses also will be there. Based on that we will be say it as simple, complex and compound sentences. Let us see the kinds of sentences based on the clauses. Look at the textbook. Sentences are of three kinds. Here I am telling based on the clauses it is of three kinds. Otherwise you may think that interrogative sentence, exclamatory sentence, imperative sentences and all, that is kinds of sentence, but here kinds of sentences based on the clauses: simple sentence, complex sentence and compound sentence. They have been discussed already in your 11th standard. Let us see one by one. First one, simple sentence. So first you observe the following sentences. Look at the following sentences. There is a solution to every problem. Work with dedication to achieve success. The path to success is highly complicated. A golden key can open any door. In the event of your missing the bus, take a taxi. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. The chief guest arrived in a great haste. So a simple sentence has only one finite verb. In all the above sentences, you can find in each sentence only one finite verb will be there. So you have to remember what is finite and non-finite verbs. So only finite verb changes based on the subject, or if it is past tense also it may change. Based on the number also it will change. For example, he likes music. But if I say it in past tense, he liked. So the word likes changed into liked. So if I use that for plural, they like music. So likes, liked, liked. It is going on changing. So if it is changing, that is finite verb. That finite verb only will be there in all these simple sentences. So we need not consider the non-finite verbs at all, like to infinitive. To like, liking, that and all non-finite, that can be added anywhere. In the phrases also it will be there. Okay, I hope you understood. So in the simple sentence has only one finite verb. Simple sentences are used to depict universal truths, facts and descriptions. A simple sentence has just one independent clause. Only one clause will be there in a simple sentence. So the simple sentence and independent clauses remain same. So there may be some phrases. It has only one subject and one predicate. Verb and other words are called predicate. Subject and predicate will be there. A simple sentence may have subject complement, object complements, adverbial phrases and non-finite verbs. Just now only I said about non-finite verbs. So like two infinitives, to change, to like, to meet, like that, or liking. So gerund form also, liking, changing, writing, speaking. This ing form also non-finite verbs, that will be there in any sentences, whether it is simple or complex or compound sentence. So now just to check your understanding, you can do this task. Pick out the finite verbs in the following sentences. So you have to identify the finite verbs or verb in the sentence. Finite verb in the sentence. For example, you can solve this problem in different ways. Can solve is the verb here. Finite verb in the sentence, solve alone you can underline. Or you can underline the verb, can solve. Likewise, you underline the verb, only finite verbs in the following sentences. The second task is read the following passage and identify the simple sentences. So a sentence means beginning with a capital letter or ending in full stop or question mark or exclamatory mark. So one sentence, you identify the sentence, first sentence. If it is simple, you put it in bracket and read the second sentence. And if it is simple sentence, put it in bracket. Otherwise, you go to the next one, right? So it is just to identify. So if you want to underline, you can do it, no problem. So that is the passage, read it and you can identify the simple sentences alone just by putting brackets. Then next, complex sentence. What is complex sentence? In simple sentence, only one independent clause will be there. And now we can recall the complex sentence, difference between a phrase and a clause. What is phrase? A phrase is a group of words without a finite verb in it. No finite verb in the phrase. Non-finite verb may be there, but finite verb will not be there. It does not give complete sense. It will give some sense, but not complete sense. Example, my new watch. Here three words are there, more than two words. So, my new watch. It is a group of words. It is giving some sense, but not complete sense. It is not a sentence. A barking dog. The wise. The brave, etc. are example for phrases. Likewise, in case of, due to, on account of, in my opinion, all these are example for phrases. Clauses, a clause is a group of words with a finite verb in it. Definitely there should be one finite verb. It may or may not make complete sense, because there are two types of clauses. One is main clause, another one is subordinate clause. The subordinate clause, it will not give complete meaning without the support of, without depending the main clause. So it may or may not give complete sense, but it will have a finite verb in it. Example, my watch that is new, a dog that is barking, people who are wise, those who are brave. All these are examples for a clause. So you should know what is main clause and what is subordinate clause. In the previous video I explained it very clearly, what is main clause and subordinate clause. Go through that. Which conjunction should be used, that also explained in the previous video. Look at the following sentence. I have lost the watch that you gave me. So it is a sentence. I have lost the watch that you gave me. Here one sentence, but two clauses are there. I have lost. Whether it is giving complete sense or not? Yes, it is giving complete sense. So it is a main clause. Another word for main clause is independent clause. Independently, it will be giving meaning. So, independently giving the meaning. That you gave me, it is a subordinate clause. The clause depends on the main clause for its meaning to be completed. That you gave me. Gave is the verb here. It has a subject, verb, its object, etc. But it is joined using subordinate conjunction that. That you gave me, then the meaning is incomplete without the support of, without depending the main clause. Okay, right. So what is complex sentence? It has a main clause and one or more subordinate clauses joined using a subordinate conjunction, that. So it will be called as clause marker, or that is subordinate conjunction. The above sentence is an example of a complex sentence. A complex sentence has one main clause and one or more subordinate clauses. So complex sentence is, it has one main clause, that means one independent clause, and others are subordinate clauses. Now task for you, look at the following complex sentences.
circle the main clauses and underline the subordinate clauses. Or just you underline the two clauses and above that you mention whether it is main clause or subordinate clause. If it is main clause, you can mention MC, and if it is subordinate clause, you can use SC. For example, nobody knows when the power supply will resume. Nobody knows. It is main clause. So you can underline it and above that you can write MC. When the power supply will resume. That is subordinate clause. Underline it and above that you can write SC. Then underline or put a bracket. Okay, next four sentences you have to do it. And identify main clause and subordinate clause. When you write subordinate clause, you use along with the subordinative conjunction. For example, when the power supply, the conjunction is when. Along with when, you have to write subordinate clause. Okay. Another task. Pick out the complex sentences in the following passage. Just like what you did for simple sentence, here you are going to do it for complex sentence. You identify the complex sentence, that alone you can put it inside bracket. The last one is compound sentence. So example, look at the following sentences. Honesty promotes character and dishonesty destroys it. I repeat, honesty promotes character and dishonesty destroys it. You can analyze this sentence. Honesty promotes character. It is a subject and a predicate. Finite verb is there, promotes. So it is a clause, main clause. So main clause number one we can put, because two main clauses are here. Main clause one. And dishonesty destroys it. It is main clause number two. Dishonesty destroys it also as a subject and predicate, and it is giving complete meaning just like the first main clause. So main clause number two. It is joined by using the conjunction or coordinative conjunction and. So once again you can watch the previous video explaining subordinating conjunction and coordinating conjunction. In compound sentence we have to use coordinating conjunction and. And some more conjunctions are but, or, etc. So mostly and, but, or. Along with and so also we can use. It depends on the sentence. Two main clauses connected by a conjunction form a compound sentence. Which conjunction? Coordinative conjunction. So do this task. Identify the two main clauses and conjunctions in each of the following sentences. So put the main clause inside bracket and you can mention MC1, MC2. Main clause 1, main clause 2, and underline the conjunction. First one I will do it. It started raining suddenly. So it is main clause number 1. People ran for shelter. Main clause number 2. And conjunction, coordinative conjunction. Just to mention C, that is enough. Or C-U-N-J. C-U-N-J. Sorry, C-O-N-J. For conjunction. So other three sentences, four sentences, you can do it yourself. So just like simple and complex, here you are going to pick out the compound sentences. So you read the entire passage, wherever the compound sentence is used, put it inside the bracket. Don't break the sentence. A sentence begins with a capital and ending in full stop, question mark or exclamatory mark. So read the entire passage and identify whether it is compound sentence. Then put it inside the bracket. Okay, thank you. I hope you understood. And you can do this third task just by putting the number, match the two clauses. Complete the sentences choosing the right ending. that may be main clause, subordinate clause, or even phrase. Whatever it is, you match it, put a number. Okay, thank you.